Joshua is the first single that I put out since my first EP. I released it November of 2016. Time is a little stranger now. I released it November of 2016, and it's about right when I moved to LA. I had nobody. Like, I had a couple friends who went to USC, but I was like really not okay, and I was watching a lot of TV, gained a lot of weight. I was like really depressed. It wasn't very good. I finally connected up with some people that I knew at USC, and they were like, let's plan a camping trip. And I was like, yes, like that's what I need to do. I need to go out and be in the wilderness, because LA is really central to a lot of different nature places. So it really influenced me in a very positive way. A, actual Joshua Tree is amazing. B, it was my first experience in LA with like friends, having a good time. Like, we drank beer, we had campfires, we went on these like crazy long hikes, and we got lost, and like got a flat tire, and like all these just crazy things happened, and it was so fun and really brief. And I'm not like super best friends with the people that I went on this trip with, but it was a really amazing time, but I love the song. It feels good every time I sing it, because I just go back to being on that trip, and it's really beautiful. So, Out Now is an interesting song for me, because most things that I write are really true to my life. Like shit that has happened to me, that I think about, that I feel, or that's happening to the immediate people around me. Out Now was a little bit different. I co-wrote this song with my friend. I was actually driving up north to visit my boyfriend, who used to live 6 hours from me. And I was driving in the car, and my friend sent me a voice memo of a chord progression. And I was like, dude, that's sick. And I just listened. I like put it on repeat in my car on a 6 hour drive, and I ended up just coming up with this melody in this song, which is inspired by my life, but it's more dramatized than anything that's actually happened to me in a romantic kind of sphere. Something that I went through, but I definitely dramatized that song a little bit. But it was really cool the way that it came together, because I was just in the car with nothing to do, and I ended up writing this whole song to like a 30-second voice memo, and it turned out really well. And I feel so good about the song, and I love the song, and it's kind of like an upbeat pop song, but it's also kind of dark, and I love that about it. It was really fun to do, it's fun to play, I love the music video that we made for it. So, for Better Off, Haley and I wrote this song together, and we weren't sure if anything was gonna happen to it. We just sat down, and I was like, I need to write. Like, I was feeling a lot of things. I was really upset about this friendship that I was trying to have with this person, and then she just disappeared on me, and I was like, that really affected me, because that never happened to me before. In such like a dramatic way. It's so hard, getting nothing in return. Like, I'd never been cut out like that before, and that like really hurt me, and so I wanted to write a song, and she is an amazing songwriter and a really talented musician, and she writes a lot of music too. She's a songwriter. We had a couple beers, we were like sitting on the floor with all these blankets and a bean, like my bean bag, and it just like happened. And so then to be able to translate that on stage, like when we play, and to be able to like sit next to her and then like look at her while we're singing together is really, really cool. Well, I try. So Docs is really specific as well, and I was sitting here and I was thinking, I was sitting in that red chair with that guitar, and I was sitting there and I was thinking about my home, which you guys just all saw. I was thinking about my home and how it's it's strange to call a place your home when you're a renter, honestly. Like, it's never really yours. Like, you could get kicked out at any moment. So how do you take, or you could just like need to leave. So it's like, how do you take something that's like a very generic place that was empty once and fill it with you and like make it you? I spent so much time with significant others and older men in my life who were like mentors to me or whatever, who were like, men don't like short hair. And I was like, okay. And so I had long hair because I was insecure. And then I finally was like, that's so stupid. Like, I wasn't sure how I was gonna look, but I was like, F all of you. Like, I don't care what you think. And I went and I chopped off all my hair, and like, that was a big moment for me. And that is really the catalyst for this song, Docs. I don't do this anymore, but I would go to a bar and I'd like dress, you know, like LA cool, like in my like leather jacket with my, you know, my red lipstick or whatever, and I would just like sit there and I would just drink and I would like look around at all the people around me, and they were all doing the exact same fucking thing. Like, everyone was doing the same thing, and that like really struck me. And so I just took all these experiences that I had directly related to things that I was doing to try to like feel better, and I just put them into song.